Well, I don't know how many phases my music's gone through. I write my music according to my lifestyle. If I'm sad, I write sad music. If I'm being divorced, I write divorce albums. If I'm sexy, if I feel hot and no horny as I'm, I'll write a horny album.
One, two, three, four. There's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way.
Well, how do you feel about love?
I don't know. Love is misery. Love is miserable. I think I'll be a bachelor and I'll swing and I won't fall in love. I'll just be loveful, be kind and good and have fun. I don't feel like being miserable.
Marriage.
Miserable.
Marvin was brought up that you respect your elders, you respect your father.
As far as the Gaye family went, you know, he was the god of the Gaye family and he had to be respected. If they broke the rules of the father, then they were, you know, they were physically punished.
What did you do as a singer before you joined Motown?
Very little.
I mean, were you
professionally?
With,
you mean?
Yeah. Were you with any other groups?
Yeah. Very funny story. We had a little group. We were singing around town, Washington D.C., and we called ourselves the Marquees.
Shot than all the rest, the fastest man I see with a gun. When you see him, you better run.
Listen, baby, ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby.
If you need me, call me. No matter where you are, no matter how far.
Don't worry, baby.
Just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry, cause baby, there ain't no mountain high enough.
I don't know what the magic or the electricity was between Tammy Terrell and Marvin Gaye, but you could see that there was a genuine devotion for each other.
Their relationship was totally a sister and brother relationship.
She was singing with Marvin at a college gig in Virginia, and she just collapsed on stage after a few numbers and was taken backstage, and people thought, you know, not too much of it at the time.
She was diagnosed with a brain tumour. She was operated on several times, and she went back to work.
But Tammy never recovered, and her condition gradually deteriorated until she died in 1970.
I think Marvin was totally devastated by the whole thing. I think it was totally, and I don't know that he ever really got over Tammy's death.
To answer questions that make me appear that weak, but being an honest soul, I have to tell you, yes, I was quite close to that point at one time during my 4-year hiatus. Considering it, yes.
The whole...
It's called, I was a manic depressant. I was at my lowest ebb. I really didn't feel like I was loved. And because I didn't feel loved, I felt useless.
When Gaye approached Lions coach Joe Schmidt about trying out for the team, Schmidt asked him if he had any game tape. That's when the coach learned that Marvin Gaye had no formal football experience, in college or even in high school. Undeterred, Gaye told Schmidt, quote, "If you give me a chance, the first time I touch the ball, I'll score a touchdown." Schmidt wasn't willing to let one of Motown's biggest stars get injured, however, ending Marvin Gaye's NFL career before it even began.
One thing was I was undergoing two divorces at the same time, which can be rather traumatic by itself. And then I was in bankruptcy. All my property had been confiscated, and there was a lot of money and a lot of property, millions of dollars, and that was rough, leaving me penniless. And then I was really having quite a political upheaval with Motown at the time, and we weren't getting on at all. And I was really broke. And things didn't look too good, so I was stuck in this forest, and I couldn't see myself. Oh yeah, I didn't tell you, I owed the government $4 million too, so that's enough to leave the country, you know what I mean?
You owed the government $4 million?
I forgot to tell you that. I just want everybody to know why I got the heck out of Dodge.
Let's go. stripes and pride.
It was through an argument that Marvin's dad was having with his mother that got Marvin so incensed, because he could not stand by and let his mother take the verbal abuse that his dad was giving her.
This turned into an argument between Marvin and the father, and there was a bit of pushing, and then Marvin actually hit the father. The father says, "I brought you into the world, and I can take you out."
He pushed his dad right to the limit, and dad just got the gun from behind the pillow and went bang, bang.
I think you're one for myself. As long as I know you have a humble mind, and as long as you know there's a guard upstairs, you can call on him and respect the people. I think you're a real wonderful person. I'm gonna give that to you as my son. And I'm proud of you, really am.
Stupid mind, but I go crazy when I can't find it.
I've got this habit. I could never figure where to store it. Thank you. So my dad sort of stores it behind his ear here.
Mm-hmm.
And when I need a quick, you know, I always store it behind there, and I can.
How's the flavor when it comes back?
Well, it's good because I keep my ears very clean for that purpose.
Mm.